This video demonstrates joining tables by using Kusto Query Language, or more simply, KQL. Microsoft 365 Defender logs massive amounts of data about apps, emails, endpoints, and identities. By themselves, these tables provide a wealth of information. But combined, you can derive more meaning from them. For example, this query joins the email events and identity logon events tables to find emails containing a URL from a malicious domain, followed shortly by a login. That's powerful stuff right there. In this video, I assume you have at least basic understanding of KQL. If not, please watch our tutorial before continuing here. Getting started with table joins is easy. Here are two simple tables. In each, the first column is named ID, and the second, value. Joining the left table to the right table adds a relationship to the data that wasn't obvious before. To join two tables, there must be a key value that's common in both. In this case, we'll join them on the column called ID. We'll start with the first row of the left table. The ID is 0, and we'll find rows in the second table that have the same value in the ID column. In this case, there's only one, so we'll create a new table that combines the columns of both tables in one row. This repeats for each row in the left table. One at a time, we match rows in the left table to rows in the right table by using the key value, or ID in this case. It's common for a key from the left table to match more than one row in the right table. When that happens, the row in the first table is duplicated and paired with each matching row in the right table. That's all there is to it. Not too bad. Of course, there are different types of joins that can make things a bit more complicated to understand, but now you understand the fundamental idea. Moving on to the query editor in Advanced Hunting, I'm going to show you what this looks like in KQL. But instead of using actual tables, I'll just create two small tables that will help you better understand what's happening. I've aptly named them left table and right table. A query on the left table returns the three rows you expect. Likewise, a query on the right table by itself returns all its rows, 5 in this case. The KQL to join these tables is simple. This query joins the left table to the right table, using ID as the key for both tables. And the results are what I promised they'd be. They match each row in the first table to one or more rows in the second table. As you'd expect, there can be some nuance to joining tables in KQL, and one of the bigger ones is choosing the right type of join, also called a join flavor. The default join flavor in KQL is inner unique. Based on the join key, it deduplicates the data in the left table before joining it to the right table. As a result, the results are missing rows from the left table, including hola and ciao, because the key values 0 and 1 appear twice each. There are times when this might precisely be what you want, but oftentimes, deduplication could lead to misdetections. The solution is to use the standard inner join flavor, which is the default in SQL. It combines every row in every table based on matching key values. The results here are what you were really expecting to see, right? What you've learned here will help you to create some powerful queries that create meaningful connections between tables. It'll get you through a lot of what you need to do. But as you'd expect, there are other join flavors and a good bit of nuance that'll help you create even more advanced queries. To learn more about them, I encourage you to see the article titled "Get Expert Training on Advanced Hunting" for a deeper dive. Joining tables is a powerful way to gain new insights from the data that Microsoft 365 Defender logs. To learn more about advanced hunting, see Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.